comedian. He's a real rookie, but you're absolutely gonna love it. Give it up for Jake Watton, everybody! Got any freshmen here tonight? I remember when I was a freshman, everyone used to tell me the same thing, you know? Gotta try some new stuff. College is all about experience. You could be anyone you want to be. So the first thing I tried out, I tried to be on the varsity baseball team. That didn't work. Apparently shitty kids don't get to play the outfield anymore. The second thing I tried was stand-up comedy. That's not working out. So then I tried out for the Beelzebubs. Now, I had no prior singing experience, but maybe the Bubs weren't looking for singers right here. So I get to my audition, I walk in, and the song I decided to sing was Stand By Me, a classic. Everyone knows it. I've heard it 100 times. So I walk up, and the first line is, "When the night has come and the land is dark." So naturally, I go, "When the night is dark." Yeah, so those are not the right words. I automatically had this angel and devil complex going on. The angel's like, "It's all right, man. We still got this." And the devil's like, "Are you fucking kidding me? No fucking way. You fucked up the words you can't say, and you were breastfed until you were 11, you pussy." It's like, "What the hell, man?" He's like, "Sorry, I just thought I'd kick you while you were down. It's my job." So the next line is, "And the land is dark." In order to compensate for my previous mistake, I say, "And the land has come." And the devil's back, and he's like, "And the land has come? How does land come? You're done, dude." And the angel's like, "Look, man, you gotta help me help you." So I finish the song, and I move on to the next phase. They say, "Can you sing some scales for us?" And I was like, "Some scales!" The devil was like, "Yeah, sick joke. Now they think you're a dick, too." The angel was like, "Yeah, you're a fucking dick." Then I get to the next phase, which is the question phase. One guy asks me, "You're standing in the middle of a coliseum. You're surrounded by an endless army of 5-year-olds. You get one weapon. How many of them can you fight off before they get to you?" I was like, "Easy, hatchet, 25. Now, they all kind of sit back like, "What the fuck?" But there was one guy in the Beelzebubs who was taking notes the whole time, and he looks up, he's like, "Hatchet, 25. Why?" He's like, "Easy. I take the hatchet, swing it like a baseball bat. Usually I'm not holding the microphone while I'm doing it, so I'd use 2 hands. And I take out six 5-year-olds. Six 5-year-olds per swing, and I take 4 swings. Now, I don't know how many of you guys are math majors, but 6 times 4 is 24. 24 does not equal 25, and I have thus proven to the Beelzebubs that I have no redeeming qualities. Nothing about me would make them want me in their club. So I didn't get into the Bubs. And even worse, I live in constant fear of 5-year-olds. When I walk down the street, if I see one, usually accompanied by his mother, I kind of give him a look like, "What's up, motherfucker? You don't wanna fuck with me? I've been watching a lot of UFC lately, bro." And then they kind of hide behind their moms, and at this point I usually bend down and say something like, "What's up, buddy? How you doing? Hide behind your mom over there? Yeah. Thought that'd be a good idea?" Well, as it turns out, mothers aren't immune to hatchets.